5, 4, 3, 2.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Good morning, CV. It's Brooke and Alexa here with your announcements for March 29th, 2021.
Attention seniors, the senior graduation project due date is upon us. Please submit your paperwork to the Shelby file. The class code is 3YPNP. This is due on April 5th. Email or go see Ms. Jones or Ms. Kostlick for assistance or more information.
Attention sophomores and freshmen. The Guidance Office will be hosting a trip to the Beaver County Career and Technology Center for students who are interested in attending a program there next year.
The BCCTC has 17 training programs available for students. An informational email was sent out last week. Please check your email and contact your counselor if you're interested in attending.
Attention all seniors. Scholarship season is well underway. There are currently 18 scholarships that are due between now and the end of this week.
Remember, the office will be closed over the break, and all applications need to be processed before this Thursday. An email was sent to all seniors listing the date the guidance office needs each scholarship application.
Attention NHS students. The National Honor Society will be collecting items for the Beaver County Humane Society from Monday, March 29th through Monday, April 12th.
Some items in high demand include dog and cat food, cleaning supplies, hand sanitizer, and laundry detergent. All items can be dropped off in Ms. Jones' room, North B114.
Attention students, prom tickets will go on sale next Tuesday, April 6th through next Friday, April 9th. Tickets will be on sale on the K-12 Payment Center live at 8 a.m. On Tuesday, tickets will be $50 for an individual and $100 per couple.
Reminder, no outside guests or students who have graduated are permitted to attend the prom. Juniors and seniors can attend, and sophomores can attend if they're asked by a junior or senior.
T-shirts will also be on sale at this time. A picture of the shirts will be emailed out as soon as possible. Shirts are $10 for sizes small through extra large, $11 for double XL, and $12 for triple XL.
If you have any questions, please email Ms. McCracken or Ms. Kramer.
Today, boys varsity baseball pitches against Ambridge at home at 4:15. Good luck, boys.
That's all we have for you today, CV. Now here's a special segment on the pets of CV TV with Carolyn and Chloe.
Hey, CV, it's Carolyn and Chloe back with a special segment on meeting the pets of our CV TV family.
Pets are a big part of people's lives, but go unnoticed by our school peers.
Since we aren't allowed to bring them to school, we figured we'd bring them to you online in a little Get to Know Them segment.
This way, everyone gets to see our fluffy friends in the way we do.
When you think of a pet, you probably think of a dog, cat, bunny, or even a snake.
Scientists believe that the first pet was actually a dog, considering the proceeds of animal domestication, which dates back to over 14,000 years ago.
If you're going to have a pet in your home, you want it to be domesticated, so they can be your companion.
Some criteria that an animal has to meet to be considered a domesticated animal is maturing quickly, being able to reproduce, being gentle by nature, and has to conform to a social structure so that it recognizes that the human is their leader.
Having a pet can help manage depression, low stress, and just overall happiness to the owner.
Owning a pet can also increase your fitness, since you'll most likely have to walk your pet or play with them on a day-to-day basis.
Pets are also amazing protection, especially if you are living alone.
Surveys and studies have shown that most households in the United States have at least one pet.
We were able to interview some of our CVTV members and ask them about their pets.
Hey, CB, I'm here with Emma.
Hi.
And I'm going to ask her some questions about a pet. So, do you have any pets?
Yes, I have 2 dogs.
Oh, and how old are they?
6 and 4.
Oh, fun. And what are their names?
Addie and Ella.
Those are cute names. Mm-hmm. And what's your favorite thing to do with them?
Probably play with them. They're kind of boring dogs.
All right, thank you.
You're welcome.
Hey, CB, I'm here with Sid, and I'm going to ask her some questions about pets. So, do you have any pets?
Yeah, I have 4 cats and 1 guinea pig.
Wow, and when did you first get all of them?
Well, 3 of the cats I got when I was probably in elementary school, and then my youngest cat I got like freshman year, and then my guinea pig is probably 5 years old.
Wow. Okay, and what are all their names?
There's Angus, Ribeye, Spanky, Buttons, and then my guinea pig is Ralphie.
Clever names. And what's your favorite thing to do with all of them?
I like to sit on my couch and watch TV with them next to me.
It seems like our CBTV members have some pretty interesting pets.
Now here's a montage of the rest of our CBTV members' 4-legged friends.
Who let the dogs out?
Was nice, the party was pumping.
Hey, yeah. V-I-O.
And everybody having a ball.
V-I-O.
Until the fellas started in calling.
V-I-O.
And the girls respond to the call. I have a pool with shout out.
Who let the dogs out?
Bash Gruffy, get back, you flea infesting mongrel. Gonna tell myself I'm man, no get angry.
Hey,
yeah,
V-I-O.
2 Eddie girls calling them canine. Hey,
V-I-O.
But they tell me, hey man, start up the party.
V-I-O.
You put a woman in front and a man behind. I have a woman shout out.
Who let the dogs out?
Wow, it looks like a lot of our members have a furry companion with them at home.
Having an animal at home can do wonders for someone's mental health and physical health.
We hope that you enjoyed seeing our CBTV families and pets as much as we did.
That's all we have for you today, CB. Have an amazing day.